Good evening, welcome back to Be Rich. So for part 2 of this week, Adira is back with your questions. I am trying to take them as much as I can.
Yes, hi sir.
Hi.
So we have a question from Johnson Stalin. He asks, in all the videos about rent versus buy, you are advising us, unless the EMI is as same as the rent you are paying for, don't purchase home. But what if we are getting ready for marriage, as most of the proposals are asking if we have own house for the groom?
No, I don't think this marriage is a reason for you to enter into a decision to buy a house. A house is a long-term investment. If you buy a house, you are buying for next 25 years. You will pay more in interest than the cost of the house. So you will never recover the cost, and that is why I am saying that. So, if just because you want to get married and you have a house, then I rather say decline that girl, because the girl should marry the house and not me. I don't have a house. My wife still married me. And I still don't have a house in my name.
Okay. And then, we have a lot of youngsters who are actually our fans, and they still send us mails on how I'm just 16, 15 and I'm willing to invest. And they ask, should we really know all about stocks and then start with it, or should I read books, and what kind of books do you want to recommend them?
Well, I have done this several times. Well, there are three sets of books by Peter Lynch, who was one of the greatest mutual fund managers. You need to read those three sets of books. You can read, before reading that, you can read my green book. The green book talks about the basics of what is money. Then you can read the three books by Peter Lynch. And then you can read my red book and The Intelligent Investor. If you read these five books, you will get a fair idea of what is a market. And then you can buy. And every day you have to read Business Standard and Mint. Business Standard and Mint both are available on the net. And you get a fair idea of how the market works. And then you can buy. But in India, the problem is till you are 18, you cannot have your own DMAT account. So you will have to get your father to open a DMAT account. I started at 16 or 15, I started trading in my father's name, and then I've been trading ever since then, that is, I've been investing ever since then. So if you are less than 18, your parents have to open an account for you in their name and you have to buy. If you are 18 plus, you have your own PAN card, you can invest yourself.
They think without knowing about stock market, they don't want to invest, but they have a lot of interest in it.
Then you have to sit patiently and read these 5 or 6 books. You will understand what is the stock market.
Okay. And there are a lot of clients who ask us, like, what US stocks we can invest. So, do you have anything to say?
No. Again, if those who want to buy US stocks, minimum have to invest $1,000 to be serious. So, you have to look at investing about 80,000 rupees every time. Those who are serious and want to invest that kind of money regularly can definitely send a mail to moneypager@gmail.com. And girls like you will reply on how to do it.
Okay. How should youngsters handle lockdown?
No, it's a lockdown is a very difficult time. In the sense, this is happening. It has not happened in my father's lifetime. My father was born in 1938. The previous lockdown was between 1914 and 1918. The Spanish flu of 1914 to 19. My grandfather was born in 1915. So, it is as big as this is. 105-year-old, so nobody has done this before. What you have to do is you have to stay in the present moment. You don't worry too much about the past. You don't think too much about the future. You stay in the present. Today, this generation is very lucky. They have a laptop, they have a computer, they have a smartphone, and they have unlimited internet. So this is actually a time when you get a lot of time, and you have access to lot of all the subjects in the world. You have access in the internet. What I find is more students are interested in movies and those kind of frivolous things. But this is a time when they'll never get this time in their life again. They can work on developing their skills in one particular area. So if you want to develop your skill in one particular area, you go down, watch YouTubes in that area, read books in that area, start with the lowest level. You get a lot of resources on the internet. In fact, the internet has more free books than the entire library of Alexandria. In the old world, Alexandria had the largest library of books. You have more books. So you can really master any subject if you put your mind to it in this period. But I don't think there will be a lockdown this time. Schools and colleges may be closed, but offices and especially those who have got double vaccinated will be allowed to work. That is what I think.
Okay. And now it is always said that at any age, people can prove who they are, isn't it?
Yes.
But do you think at this point is where you have to actually work hard invest?
No. I don't believe that. Some of the best businesses in this world have been started by people who are above 60.
It's not just about business, like as a character-wise or their
profession. No, I'm just telling you. Mm-hmm. So there is no age. You can say that I will succeed only at this age. So it depends on a lot of factors. So first, one should never give up. Like Kentucky Fried Chicken, the man started after he was 60. Ray Kroc of McDonald's started this after he was 60. In our own Tamil Nadu, in Madras, in Grand Suites, G. Natarajan started after he was 60. So I'm giving you three examples of that. But the journey is very long. And like I'm talking about the principle of compounding. Like if you have one mango tree and the fruit from the mango tree falls and the seed becomes another mango tree. So it keeps on increasing and then it starts going in a geometric fashion. So the earlier you start and what happens is it gives you greater time to experiment and pick what career you want. If you look at me, I started as an engineer. Finished engineering, I didn't like it. Then I decided, I did some programming, I didn't like it. Then went to sales, I was a very good sales guy. I did sales for many years. From age 24 to 37, I did sales. At 37, I stopped selling. I was always investing on the side. At 37, I decided to become a full-time investor. So then I became a full-time investor at 37. That's about 18 years back, yes, about 18 years back in 2003. So I became a full-time investor. Once having turned a full-time investor, then I started writing in Facebook. And then people called me on TV and then it moved on. So somebody had told me in 2003 that a lot of people in social media will know you. I would have laughed because I didn't even know what was social media then. Though I started Facebook in 2007, registered in Facebook in 2007, I actually started writing in Facebook only in 2013. So, you don't know why, where life will take you and where you will be successful and popular. If somebody had told me in 2003, I'll be popular and people will know me in Tamil Nadu as an investor and as a person who understands finance, I wouldn't have believed it myself. But I was continuously accumulating knowledge on finance and economics. And in 2013, when I started writing in Facebook, a lot of people started following me. One person who was following me was working in a television channel. He called me to a TV station to talk about it. And then one thing led to another thing. And at time of demonetization, nobody knew what it was. I was one of the very few who knew what it was. So then they started calling me. So then in 45 days, I became very, because every day I was in television. And then I started talking in YouTube. Then no looking back. There was no idea in 2003 or 4 that there is going to be something like YouTube. I don't think YouTube was there then. But there's going to be something YouTube. And then I'm going to become a YouTube star or a Facebook star. So I became an investor. No. So you don't know when the success will come, from where it will come. But in your chosen area, you have to keep on adding your skills by continuously learning at all times.
There are some people who says that I'm not able to find what my talent.
You have to wait patiently, you will get your time. I thought engineering was my passion. It was not. Then I thought programming was my passion. I tried it for 2-3 years. It was not. Then I was a pretty decent programmer. And then I decided sales was my passion. I sold for 15 years. I was a salesman. And then I decided, no, I will not do it. I think I'm going to get more rewards by being an investor. And at that time, I had almost detached myself from the world in the sense that all my previous connections had gone. Most of my friends were all in sales. So I lost touch with most of them. And I was living in my house alone, using a computer to buy stocks and buying and reading stuff. And I had about 10 or 15 friends, handful of friends. I used to sit in a coffee shop the whole day and discuss with my friend. And several days between 10 to 4, I have been sitting in a coffee shop discussing stocks and investments. Nobody even looked at me. But today, if I go and sit in a coffee shop, I can't sit for 6 hours. People will come and disturb me. But what I'm saying is, I didn't know this is what is going to happen. I was only working on my skill set. So if you continue to work on your skill set, and then things happen. So you don't know which way doors will open.
So you're asking the youngsters to be hopeful and...
Hopeful. Pick areas which you find interesting today. It may not be interesting. When you don't, you find something more interesting, then transfer this learning to that.
Thank you. That's a nice advice.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much. I had a pleasant time. Thank you for watching Be Rich.
Thank you.
It's a great privilege and honor that so many of you in thousands have subscribed to my channel and have supported me. I have written 2 books in English, The Alchemy of Money and Ordinary Stocks, Extraordinary Profits. These books are published by us and are ready. If you want to procure a copy, send us a message to the WhatsApp number given below and my team would respond to you. If you want an Amazon Kindle copy, you can click the link below. Finally, those who wish to consult with me can send a mail to berichenglish@gmail.com. Once again, I thank you for your support.
For hot financial news reviews and economical updates, watch BeRich. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe our channel.